A solution's pH describes its acidity on a scale from 0 to 14. A solution with pH 0 is highly acidic, while a solution with pH 14 is highly basic. Acidity refers to the concentration of hydrogen ions in the solution. The greater the acidity, the greater the concentration of hydrogen ions. Accurate pH is crucial to scientific experiments because pH can significantly influence a solution's behavior. So as scientists, it's really important that we know how to measure pH in the lab to make sure we've got it right. And that's exactly what we'll learn how to do in this video. The instrument we use to measure pH in the lab is fittingly called a pH meter. It consists of an electrode, a stand to hold up the electrode, and a digital panel for controlling the instrument and displaying measurements. The electrode will measure the electrical activity of the hydrogen ions in a solution, and the panel will translate that to a pH value, ranging from 0 to 14. The electrode needs to be stored in a potassium chloride buffer and should never be allowed to dry out. She needs to stay moisturized to live her best life, don't we all? Before we can use the pH meter to take a measurement, we first need to calibrate it using a series of standard buffers with known pHs of 4, 7, and 10. Carefully remove the buffer storage tube from the electrode. Place an empty beaker underneath the electrode and rinse it with distilled water. Carefully blot it with a Kim wipe, being careful not to touch the glass bulb of the electrode itself. Instead, wick any droplets of water away from it with the wipe. The calibration should begin with the pH 7 buffer. Submerge the electrode in the buffer, but make sure it's not touching the bottom of the beaker or a stir bar if you're using one. Press the calibrate button on the pH meter panel and wait for the readout to stabilize. Different pH meters will indicate this in different ways. In our case, a line will appear over the A at the bottom right-hand corner of the readout screen. The A just stands for automatic, which means that the meter stops readings automatically when it detects that the pH has stabilized. Once that's done, remove the electrode from the buffer, hold it over the empty beaker, and repeat the rinsing and blotting steps from before. Next, repeat this process with the pH 4 buffer and pH 10 buffer. Submerge, calibrate, stabilize, rinse, and blot. This calibration procedure should be performed at least once per day. You know the saying, a pH meter calibration a day keeps the doctor away. Following calibration, you're ready to measure a solution of unknown pH. Let's find out what the pH of this tap water is. By now you're a pro at electrode submersion, but this time, instead of hitting the calibrate button, you're going to hit the read button. Wait for the readout to stabilize. pH meters will often give a little beep to let you know when they're done reading the pH, so polite. And you should now be able to see the pH measurement on the display panel. In this case, it's 9.64. Wow, that's some pretty basic tap water. pH meters are also super handy when you need to adjust your solution to a desired pH for an experiment. In this example, a basic buffer called Tris has just been added to the water. You can see the pH shoot way up and get as high as 10.5. But for our experiment, we need the Tris buffer solution to be at pH 8. So we're going to add drops of hydrochloric acid to get it down. The pH meter will help us keep track of the changes in pH as we add the acid so that we don't overshoot our desired pH. As the drops are added, the pH meter reading decreases gradually until we reach 8. Hooray! We can now use this Tris for our experiment. Now you know how to use this super important measuring tool in the lab. From now on, I hope all your pHs are nice and accurate.